Okay, we're recording. There you go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, today, for your learning pleasure, we are going to work on determining a central idea of a text and analyze its development over the course of the text, including its relationship to supporting ideas, and provide an objective summary of the text. So basically, we want to look at it. Can we decide what the main idea is? And so we're going to do that with an organizational pattern of information. So you're going to have a graphic organizer with which to work. So today, those are our objectives. And but before we get started, let's go with good things. Who has good things? Brandon.
I went to my autistic basketball game yesterday.
Cool beans. All right. Two claps. One, two. Yes.
I ate pizza yesterday.
Pizza, what kind?
Pepperoni with bacon. Mm.
Sounds good. Mm. One, two. Sammy.
My friend might come over so I can show him one side.
All right. Have fun with that. Two claps. One, two. Okay, so before we get started, we are going to watch a little video and kind of give you an idea of what the topic that we are going to be discussing is today. So, I'm going to start with a video that is right here. Oh, would somebody turn on the projector? Oh, I did turn on the projector. Good. All right. And as soon as that comes up, we will, there we go.
Thank you.
what do you think our subject is today?
About people bullying them.
All right, so we're take one of these and pass it down. When you get these, Lily, hand one back to Dana, and when you get those, Brandon, hand one back to Melissa. Okay, so question. So is bullying something, and give one to Leah. Is bullying something we have a problem with here at Goddard?
No.
No, you don't.
But in other schools, yeah.
In other schools, yes, but not here. How many of you have been bullied at this school? Hot dog. How many of you have been bullied at other schools? Okay. All right. So let's think about bullying for just a minute. So in these pieces of paper that I gave you just now, I want you to think about what I think bullying is, and I want you to complete that. How do you feel about bullying? What do you think about it? Just whatever you think about it, okay? So go ahead and write that down, what you think about bullying. Is it an issue? Is it something that, just how do you feel about it?
I forgot my pencil in my locker. Can I go get them real quick?
How about if I just give you one real quick? There you go. What about the next one? I think students should do what to resolve the issue? To solve it. What can students do if they see it? Because I have heard that there is some bullying that does go on at our school. Maybe not to the extent of other schools, but there is some that goes on. So have you seen it in our school at all? That's awesome. I'm really excited about that, really. Okay, so, but if you did, what do you think students should do? If you were to see it, what would you do? Okay, what would be your plan if you saw that? Thank you. And last, what do you think teachers should do? What should teachers do to resolve it? Okay, who wants to share? Just have a couple people for each question. So on, what do you think about bullying? Edna?
I think bullying is like mentally hurting someone.
Okay. Absolutely. What else? Somebody else. Dana.
Do I have to answer?
No. No, you don't have to.
Okay.
Okay. All right, Bianca. What do you think bullying is? Or what do you think about bullying? Okay, so people are hurting others. Okay, so what do you think students could do about this? Derek. Okay, help students that are getting bullied. Sammy?
Stand up for the other student.
Stand up for them. Okay, what do teachers need to do? Edna?
The bully gotta stop bullying.
Okay, make sure the bully stops bullying. What else? Anything else? Okay. When you go to read a passage, so we're talking about bullying, and you guys are aware of that it exists and that it goes on. And so we're going to be reading a passage so that we can talk about the central idea of a text. But before we get there, we want to have some vocabulary words, and we want to learn some vocabulary to make sure we understand exactly what the text is talking about. So you have in your possession a little yellow slip of paper with either a word and an example sentence on it or a definition on it. So I need you to get up and mingle together. Wait till the instructions are done. Thank you. Get up and mingle together and try to find your match based on your definition and their sentence example. All right, ready? Go. Once you find them, stand together. Once you find your match, go stand over there somewhere. Once you find your match. Because I only have six words and there's 13 of us, so I didn't do it. Actually, does everybody have a partner? You guys better keep looking. Do you girls have a partner? Okay, do you guys have a partner? You two? Okay, keep looking, guys. Look at the definition of the word, and then look how the word is used in your sentence, and see if they match, if they equal, like maybe give you the same ideas. Have you talked to every single person?
Yep.
Well, what do you got? Okay, so what do you got? All right. You've got a definition. You've got a word. So if you've got a word at the top, stand in a line right here. If you have a word at the top that says, like, the amend, resolve, blah, blah, blah. Okay? Now, if you have a definition, if you have a word with a sentence, stand over there. If you have a definition, stand over here. That's you. Definition, definition. Yeah, you're just going to be over here. Okay, so now go across from the person that you're across from and you stick with Dana. Stick with Dana. All right, look across from the person that you're across from and see if you're equaling. Does your thing meet her thing? Oh, isn't that amazing? So you two are a match. Go. Nope. So now you two. try it?
Nope.
Nope. What about her? All right. What about you guys? What's yours? Who equals you? Figure it out. Which one of those two equal that? Okay, so you two, and what about you guys? That's not you. What have you got? Okay, that might be, there's you guys. Who's got the other half? Who's your partner? Who's your partner? Come over here. Yes, there are you guys. Okay, now that you're together, read your word and the sentence that goes with it, and then read your definition. Okay, legislate an end to bullying. So legislate, what's the definition of legislate?
To create or control by making laws.
Okay, make laws? All right, what about you guys? I'm sorry, what? Constitute. So, and you said, okay, so you constitute is to form or to create. We know what constitutes this by what forms it or what creates it. Okay. Okay, equity. And what have you got for the definition?
Equals.
Okay, so what do we mean when we say equal?
Equality.
Equal, right? You're not up, you're not down, you're equal. Okay, over there?
Many schools have chosen to amend their rules to make it clear that bullying will not be tolerated.
Okay, so we're going to amend. Go ahead, what does that mean?
To change, to add to.
Okay, so we're going to change, we're going to either add to, or we're going to take away from it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Amend. Okay, you guys. Leanna, read yours. Okay.
Resolves. Steve's mother always lets him and his brothers resolve their own problems.
Okay.
Determination to do something, commitment.
Whoops. Where's the other definition? Mm-hmm. Well, let's listen to this too and let's see what we got here.
Resolve. I think we get in the way of things resolved to run for class president.
Okay.
Solve a problem.
Okay, so which partner should you guys be together with? Those two and? Dana, you should be over here with Jalissa. I wanted you to move, Dana. Okay, so now read your slips together. Yes.
Get in the way of Nate's resolve to run for class president.
Determination to do something, commitment.
Okay, so if you're determined. Okay, we're determined to do it. All right. Okay, you guys, how about yours?
Resolve. Steve's mother always lets him and his brothers resolve the problems themselves.
Okay.
To solve a problem.
Okay, so you have a problem. You have a problem, and you're going to solve it so everybody's okay.
Yeah.
Problem, solve it. Okay? Everybody can sit down. Keep your slip. Nope, keep it for right now. All right, so let's try to figure out a way. First of all, before we do this, Jalissa and you guys did a great job with that because you had it mixed up, right?
Yep.
So resolve had two meanings, didn't it? And so one was a noun and one was a verb. Which one is which? Sammy? That's a verb, to solve the problem, right? Okay, so solving the problem is a verb, and having determination to do something is a different kind of resolve. So there's a lot of words that have multiple meanings. So for an example, let's look at this one. If I say, run in a race, you guys know exactly what I'm talking about, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so your legs are moving, you're propelling yourself forward. What if I say to run a company? Is that the same thing?
I know what it is.
Right, but it's not the same thing as running a race, right? So run has a different meaning there. You're in charge, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what about this one? Run for office. Not the same. So if you're running for an office, what are you doing?
Running an office?
You are campaigning, right? You're trying to get elected. Okay, what about running a vacuum cleaner?
Not the same.
Not the same. You're doing a job. You're cleaning. What about if your nose runs?
Not the same.
So there were several different meanings for the same word. And that's what we have with this. So we're going to learn a little bit some signals to help us remember what these words mean. So that when we are reading the article, we'll have the idea of what they mean. And I showed you a couple of them. So let's start with equality. So for equality, we're going to go like this and end up together. Okay, so up, down, together. Ready? Go. Up, down, together. Up, down, together. All right, so we end up with our hands side by side so we know that they're equal. You don't want to have one hand above the other, okay? They're equal.
Blake Bailey, would you please report to Mr. Buzzy's cry time immediately? Blake Bailey.
Okay. And then the next one is, okay, resolve when we're determined. So if we're determined, we've got our thinking up here, so we're in our head. And then we're going to just be determined. So you make a fist and you make a determined face. Okay, I'm going to do it. All right, so up here. Everybody, up here. Up here. And go down and make your determined face. I'm going to do it. Okay, so that's resolve when it means determined. Now, if we have a conflict, we have people butting heads. Okay? So we have a conflict, but we're going to resolve it and make it all okay. All right, so we have a conflict. Everybody up. Conflict. We're going to resolve it so everything's okay. All right. Now, we are going to legislate. So we're going to make a rule. So who makes rulings in the court? The judge. So we're going to legislate. Okay? So here's our little pad that you beat on, and you're going to legislate. All right. Then, for constitute, which means to form or create, this is what forms or creates this particular thing. What constitutes being a student? You have to study, right? You have to take your books home. You have to do homework. You have to read. You have to do things you don't want to do. That constitutes being a student. But you get to learn. And you get to have new knowledge and all that sort of good stuff, so there's a benefit to it too. So form, we're just going to form, okay? Form or create. Luis, we're forming or creating. All right. Now, then the last one for amend. We're going to go forward or backward, okay? So we're either going to change it or we're going to take something off of it. Ba-ba, 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 ba-ba. All right. So now, here's the deal. I resolved that the conflict would be resolved in an equitable fashion by amending the social contract so everyone would know what constitutes equality without having to legislate new rules. Are you ready? All right, here we go. We're all going to do that. So, repeat after me. I resolved. So, I'll say it first and then you say it after me, right? I resolved.
I resolved.
That the conflict would be resolved.
That the conflict
would be resolved in an equitable fashion. By amending. The social contract, so everyone would know what constitutes equality without having to legislate new rules. rules.
New rules.
All right. So, how do you feel about that?
Good.
Okay, so what does resolved mean?
Resolved.
What's the definition? I'm resolved that I will do this. Determined. Okay, so we're determined. What does this resolve mean? Derek?
Conflict.
And everything's okay, right? So we're going to resolve, we're going to solve the conflict. We're going to make sure everybody is happy about the outcome. So we're going to conflict, resolve. All right, what about amend? If we amend something, what do? Melissa?
Change.
We could either add to it or take away from it, right? Somehow we're going to change it. And then what about legislate, Brandon? What does the judge do?
Legislate.
Not necessarily make them, but they enforce them, right? So the legislature enforces the rules, so we make the rules, we legislate things, and people have to obey them. So, boy, howdy, if you don't obey them, what's going to happen? A judge is going to nail you. All right. So here we go. We are going to do this again, one more time. Okay, I resolved. That the conflict would be resolved.
That the conflict would be resolved.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay. Okay, I'm going to let you go. Remember those things for tomorrow because we'll finish this up tomorrow.
That is little bullying paper.
Yes, keep the bullying paper. I'll get it later.
Keep the bullying paper.
Okay.
All right. You guys have a great day.
Oh my God.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. I'll take that, Bianca. Thank you, ma'am. Did I get all you guys's? Okay. I'll take those back. Thank you. That again. You can stop anytime.
Hey!